turning right, turning left. In fact, a year in 2002, I had a pretty good day on the water, right? I had 53.2 pounds on 5 fish for that day. That's a pretty good day. You know, I think I had a 12-pounder, 11-pounder, or 2 11-pounders, a 10-pounder, and a scrawny little 9-pounder that I couldn't upgrade. So, and that's exactly how I caught those fish that day. Right? I noticed, you know, as I turned, and I was using trolling boards, all right? I was trolling, it was cold weather, about, all water temperature was probably about 53, 54 degrees, right? And I was using trolling boards. These trolling boards, you know, I got them out, way out to the side of the boat, right? So when you turn this way, what do the outside boards do? They speed up. And what does the inside board do? Slow down. In fact, once I figured out that those fish, and I was going real slow anyway, so the crankbait was just kind of wobbling like that. And this is what I theorized, you know, the walleye would be sitting there following it, and as soon as that inside board would stop, and that crankbait would just sit there, he'd come up there, he'd grab it, and then when I turned the other way, the board would just keep on going backwards. Right? You like that when the board goes back and then sinks. Those are pretty big fish. So once I noticed that, I intentionally would turn the boat this way, let it sit, turn the boat that way, let it sit, turn the boat that way, and let it sit. And I would intentionally watch those boards speed up and then stall, speed up and stall, and vice versa, all right? So again, action is the next most important thing outside of location, all right? Because, you know, walleyes, they feed on sound, or I mean sight. They're sight feeders, okay? They can't see it. I believe it's harder for them to pick up on the bait, right? So sight is very important, and the action that you impart on that lure is very important, okay? After that, I think sound is probably the next thing, right? If I'm going to use rattles, I'd rather use rattles than a non-rattling bait to begin with. You know, I mean, you'll catch a lot of fish on both. You know, I'm not saying sometimes they want the rattle, sometimes they don't. But sound, I think, does play an important factor. Color, right? Anybody believe color makes a difference? Yeah, it can, all right? No doubt. You know, I mean, there's some days where I believe that, you know, that all they want is fire type, all right? But what's funny about color, right? This is one thing I'm going to just play a little devil's advocate here, you know, and try to take the opposite stance that color is important. And that I'll be catching fish deciding that that's all they want is fire tiger that day. Because I've changed all my lures to fire tiger and I'm catching them, right? But my buddy's boat that's like an eighth of a mile away, all he can catch them on is blue silver, right? So tell me that these walleyes here are colorblind to blue silver versus blue silver over there and colorblind to fire tiger. You know, Lake Erie, it's all the same. You know, I mean, you can get variances in color, but not over an eighth of a mile or so. So, you know, I mean, I think a lot of color has to do is with their ability to be able to see, right? Some colors they can see better than others, but I'm not 100% sure that color is, you know, it's not as important as location, action, right? Then color and then sound, I guess. So color and sound are kind of about right in that same plateau. You know, a lot of it has to do with confidence too, right? You know, I mean, I've done hundreds of these presentations and met a lot of great people. And one gentleman I remember in particular, he comes to me, he says, "Ted, you've got to try this lure." And I said, "Really?" He says, "Yeah, this lure, it catches all my fish." I said, "Really?" He says, "Yeah." And I asked him, "Well, how often do you put the lure on?" "All the time." So obviously, you put that same lure on all the time, you're going to catch all your fish on that same lure, right? Because he's got a lot of confidence in it. Right? And there's nothing wrong with that. If you've got a lure that you have a lot of confidence in, there's nothing wrong with that. But if you got an option of trolling 4 or 6 lures, You know, that's kind of what's nice about walleye fishing. It's kind of like a group sport, you know. You got three or four guys in the boat. I'd like everybody to start off with a different color jig to start off. All right? If you've got a favorite color, ask everybody what their favorite color is. Most likely, they all have a different favorite color. So let them start off with their favorite color. All right? Like my daughter's favorite color is pink. All right? So she always starts off with a pink jig. All right? I like green, yellow, chartreuse yellow. All right? And green. So I'll start off with that. You know, but what I'm saying is that as soon as somebody starts catching fish, trying to zero in on what it is that's causing that fish to bite, is what I'm saying. In other words, you know, if I'm out there controlling the boat, right, and then all of a sudden Joe, you know, catches that first fish, I'm watching Joe pretty close. Because first of all, I've already lost a buck. Right? Buck for the first fish, buck for the most fish, and buck for the biggest. So I've already lost a buck to Joe. So I'm watching him. When he catches that second one, I'm going to have him reel up the jig. I want to see it. Right? How is he putting the minnow on that jig? Is it a minnow or a crawler or a leech? How is he putting it on that jig? And then I'm going to watch him put it in the water, and I'm going to watch him how he's working that jig. Right? He catches that third one, all right, and he's got his hat like this. I've got my hat like that, too. Right? Serious. And finally, he's got that fourth one, and I figure out he's in 10 foot, and I'm controlling the boat in 8 foot. Guess where Joe's fishing the rest of the day? It's all a matter of trying to figure out what the fish want at that time of the day, right? You know, I mean, we've all seen it, right? I mean, one little thing can make the difference.